Thank you for joining me, and I believe you've had a lot of practice with the previous groups, the clay board, font, alignment, and the cells group. So we will be focusing our attention on the cells group. So cells basically makes it easy for us to apply certain formats to certain parts of our worksheet. So in order not to waste time, if you have any form of heading, you can actually ignore using the tools under the fonts tab for this particular under the font group for this particular exercise. So if I want to change the heading, okay, why don't I copy, then control V to paste. Now I can just delete this, then I'll merge across, then I can come and do the center. I can just go ahead and do the merge and center. So if I want to apply a different heading style, then I can come and click on the drop down arrow, which is here. Then as I go over it, get to see a lot of various styles which I can use. So if it is heading, I can pick heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4. As a title, well, probably I'm working on a cell which demands that I do the calculations and find the total. So you need not to do the formatting yourself. You already have some of these pre-formatting, if I should put it in that way, which makes it easier for you. So whenever you're solving questions or whenever you're working with the Office application and you want to be efficient, then you can just try some of these heading styles. Then we have themed cell styles. So we have data and model. So if you're dealing with data, you can make this look more attractive. If it's a warning text, you just go there, you click on it, and it's done. So try to go over these and just explore, have fun with them. Okay, good. So that is the styles bit of it. Then we look at format as your table. Normally when you create your Excel worksheet, you might probably think that, oh, this is already in rows and columns and they are in a table form, which is so wrong, because if you put it in a table form, it should have these what we call filter handles to help you manage the data set. So before you can convert a particular range into a table, you always have to go to the styles group. So control shift right, control shift down to select the entire range. Then I can come and say what format as table. So with the tables, we have sections. So we have the light section, we have the medium section, we have the dark section. So these are the available sections for the table. So if in the course of practice exercises they mention a specific table that you need to use, then you go through and you find it. So if they say medium, white table style medium was 15. So once you see medium, then you come to the medium section, then you look for it. Once you see light, then you go through the light section and you look for it. So white table light 1, we have light 2 in that particular order. So I'll just go ahead and select one of them. So once you select, then it's going to ask you, does your table have headers? Yes. So these are my headers, name K1, K2, K3, K4. Then I'll leave it checked. If it doesn't, then you uncheck. Then the system will find a way of adding headers to it automatically using the columns. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. So once you do that, now it has been converted into a table. So watch this. When we started, we had home to probably help or view on your system. But as soon as you convert it into a table, it gives you an additional tab. And this tab is what we normally term as a contextual tab. So once you insert a table, all the tools needed to format this table will be made available. So let's quickly go through them one after the other. So if you want to change the table styles, at least it's here. You need not to go back to the home tab to do that. Because when you come to the home tab, these are the styles. When you come to format that table, you also have some styles for that. But our focus will be on the contextual tab, which is the table tools. So if you want to change it, you change your mind, okay, I want this particular style, I want this particular style, I want this particular style. Or I can probably go and select this. Good. But because I've applied borders, that's how come they're not really seeing the clear picture. So I'll go ahead, come to my home tab, and take all the borders from it. I'll come and take the fill effect out. So once I do that, then you see the actual table that we selected. So as I go through it, it changes into the various colors that we want to use. So something like this. Good. And now we have what, filter button. So this is a filter button for the table. This is what we call filter button. So if you don't want it, you want to check it, gone. We have header rows. If you don't want the header rows, you want to check it, gone. If you don't want banded rows where each row is shaded differently from the next row, just with two colors. Once I take it off, that's what you get. So that is what we mean by banded rows. So if I click on banded rows, this is what you get. If I click on header rows, this is what you get. So once the header rows is active, filter button becomes active. So what do I want to do? If I want to filter, I click. I only want to see the values for the number column. I click on OK, then that's what is shown. The rest will be ignored. So this is how you try to filter the table. You can clear it. And we have other various what filter options, but we'll delve much deeper into that. I think I under the editing group, good. Then we can even sort by color and stuff like that, and even filter it by text. So all these are options you need to at least explore, find out more about when you are practicing or when you finish watching this particular session of our tutorial training. Then we have our total rule. So I need not to calculate the total. If I click on total rule, the system will automatically give me the total for the last word column. If you don't want it, you want to check. Then we have what, last column. So once you click on last column, then it adds a bit of a band or a color. If you want first column, you click, first column is activated. If you want banded rows, you click, banded rows is activated. So try to explore these options. Then once it's in the form of a table, you can more or less convert it back to the normal range. And these are some of the issues you'll be dealing with when you start practicing on the exercises and even preparing for the exam. So as you click, then it's converted back to a range, but it maintains the format of the table. You see the table tool has disappeared. If I want to convert it to a table one more time, I go to my format as a table, then I just go ahead to click, I'll say okay, then it comes back to table. So if you think there are duplicates within the data set, you click on what, remove what, duplicate. So K1 to what, K4. So it select all the headings, then I'll say what, okay. So no duplicate values were found. So assuming I come in here, I tab, then I copy this, I come and paste, I copy this, then I come and paste. So once I do this, then I say remove duplicate, the system will just go through all the columns, all the duplicates will be removed. So if you're asked to remove duplicates, or you have a large data set and you think there are duplicates in it and you want to remove them, once you click on the table, you go to its contextual tab, which is the table tool design, and you do justice to that. And there will be instances where you'll be asked to name this table. So by default, the system will name it as table 2. I created it initially, it was table 1, then we converted it to range. We have to create it again. So if I come again and convert it to range, and I go ahead to create it as a table again, obviously it should have to go up to table 3. So let's see. Okay, now it comes back to table 3. So you can actually give it a name. So let's say fits, then I hit enter. So once I do that, if I come to the name box, then automatically it adds to whatever ranges that I might have within the worksheet. So we'll talk about name ranges as we move along and how to use it in your formulas. Then we have pivot table slices. So we'll discuss that as we get to the insert tab for you to appreciate it. Then we also have what export table to a SharePoint list. And I don't think we will be using this, but you can explore and see what is there. So basically that is that for the contextual tab of the table tool. So anytime you insert an object, concentrate on the tab that comes after the last default tab in your Microsoft Office application. I don't know which one would come after this, but depending on what you have on your system, any foreign tab that comes after is what we term as a contextual tab and can be used for formatting that particular object you've inserted. So assuming I come in here, we will take a look at the insert tab and probably I just pick a shape. So after drawing the shape, automatically it gives me the contextual tab. So anything I want to do to this particular shape will be found here. I cannot get the tools from home through to QuickBooks. No, just be wasting your time doing that. Okay, we don't need that, so I'll delete it. So that is that for format as a table. Then let's look at conditional formatting. So if I have a data set, so let's see if we can remember what we did. So I'll go and paste it as just what values. Or I can paste it with what column width. Then I'll take this. I can change the color. Then apply some borders to it. So I'll say all borders. Good. So once that is done, I can just go ahead to apply some conditions. Conditional formatting. So we have highlight cell rules. So I want the system to highlight cells that are greater than 4,500 with red fill with dark red with text. So if I come in here and I type greater than, let's say, 8,000. So as I do, you see a preview greater than 500, greater than 8,000. Okay, so basically that is it. So you can explore these other options as well. So I can go, just go greater than 900. You can go ahead to change it then you click on OK. So that is what it means for using these conditional formats. So I'll go back again, conditional formatting, then I'll say what, clear rules from selected cells. Then it's been cleared. If I come in here and only select these range, this particular range, conditional formatting, we have what, bottom. So we need the top 10. Automatically the system will just pick the top 10 items for me. If you don't want the top 10, you can just change it to top 5. If you want top 2, you change it to top 2. Then you pick any of these formats, or you can customize it if you want to. So as you do it, you can change the underline, you can change the color, you can change how it feels. So you just have to explore, okay? So that is basically it, another conditional formatting. Then we have data bars. So the data bars will just help you know the differences. So you can apply more than one conditional format to your cells. This way it makes it very easy for clear rules from selected text. Yeah. So that is conditional formatting. We have what, color scale. So all these are there just to make it look attractive and appealing to whoever you're presenting the data to. Then I can just come here, clear rules from selected text. So I want you to explore all of these options. Then we have icons. So all the conditional format comes with their name. So in the course of practice, you'll be asked or required to use certain specific items. So there's a three arrows icon set conditional format. So there's icon set, there's one. Three arrows. Then we have what, indicators, which is what, three flags. So as you go through, if you don't know them, as you put your or hover your mouse over each of the items, it will give you its name. So basically that is it. So that is for conditional format, and there are a lot. So if you don't want any of these predefined formats, then you have to come and create your new rule. And the new rule can be created format only cells that contain, I only want those that are equal to a specific number, 300. So what format am I using? You click on it, then I want it to be bold and italic. So that is the first thing I want done. Then I can apply what, a border to it. So I come in here, I want the border. So come and just click, borders around it, click at the top, click at the right, click at the button. Then the borders around it, I want it in this particular color. Then when I finish, I want a particular pattern style. So I can pick this, then I can pick what, a color to be applied to it. So you can just format it in whichever way that you want. You can even format it as a currency. So if I want it as Ghana Cedis GHS, I just go ahead, and if I want it into two decimal places, it is also there. Then I click on what, okay. So once I do that, I click on okay, then the system will just automatically format that particular cell for me, which is equal to 300. So once you see something like this, then it means the number or whatever is contained in there and exceeds the column width. So what you need to do is you just position it in between K and L, you double tap, then automatically it expands it to, for you to see. So once you see the hashtag, then it means there is a number contained in this particular cell, but you are not seeing the full length because the column width is too small for it. So basically, that is what the conditional formatting is all about. So you can create your own rules after selecting a cell range. Use a formula to determine which one to format. So I want you to go through it and just explore. So after watching this video, don't just sit down. You need to explore, and that's the only way you will get better. So we will continue our next lesson with the editing group. Then we will conclude with the number group for the home tab. Then I have about 78 real world related tasks that will help you solidify your understanding after watching all the series under this particular home tab. So I will take the styles group of my list. Now we are left with only two groups, so I'll take you through the remaining two in my next episodes. Okay.